with hints of claws embedded in the amorphous shapes. On closer examination, the claws appear to be broken. I don't think that's it either. Damn, nice. They respect the forces of power, so that made sense. That's a lot like the Codex Alera from Jim Butcher. There is a race there that's kinda beast-like and they have the same attitude. Okay. Find the murals in the darkened hollow, find the murals in the fractured depths. So do I need to find the same murals or different ones? Oh, I already found the ones in the fractured depths. So I'm missing... Oh, no, I'm not missing anything. Okay, apparently I found everything already. No, locate and examine the beastman murals. Okay, I'm missing one, I think, in the Darkened Hallows. Alright. How the hell do I get to the Darkened Hallows? Just checking. I'll use the teleporter. So I'm missing one mural. That's interesting. I like what they have done. This is a much better... Well... Story-wise, I find it a much better DLC than the White March one. The White March did add a lot of mechanics like the soulbind weapons and stuff like that. So that was interesting, but... Alright, we need the... Darkened Hollow. I have no idea how to get there though, so I guess teleporter is... Oh, nice. It actually says... There we go. That's pretty cool. Good job on the map there. Otherwise, I would have to go to its teleporter and try to see where it leads. They did add the more random events throughout the world. What is the fourth one? But I don't know how significant it is. You'll get more out of it if you play the game fresh, obviously. Oh, I can open this too, I think, now. I don't think the map actually shows the murals though. So the murals were painted by the beastmen, or at least an ancient form of beastmen which were more artistically inclined, I guess, because the current form isn't not that much. I haven't been here. Let's look around a bit. Aha, there is the one mural, which was the maze, I remember that one. I think the only area I missed is this one, so I'm guessing it's somewhere over there. Probably. What's this? Ah, I might have missed more than one area. I don't see an entrance though. Alright, we'll try out the new sigil. There we go.
Can't do that.
You can't do that. Oh, there is the other mural. Couldn't have gotten to it, I guess, before.
Slow down. Let's take a closer look.
That's not how you disarm traps.
There. See that?
Some fish. Sure. Useful. A single color mark of palm and split fingers. So everyone that came here was a kind of beastman, I guess. At least initially. Two distinct times of print. What does that mean? Okay, I'm guessing now we can go back. Yep. It's a ghost of the abyss, right? The abyss with thee.
Thank you.
Hey, where the hell am I going? I think that was it. Could be wrong. But I'm not wrong. Okay. I don't know about that. I think maybe they were meant to fight the Bane. I don't think so. I think they were both the same though. I'm not sure I gave the right answer on the second question. I don't know. What the hell is Bolvrix? This makes more sense to be on the same mystical forces. I guess we picked this one for now, but I don't know if it's the correct answer. Well, we saved. I want to see what happens if you pick the other answers. Especially about the Bane and the correct. They could be responsible for being the recent foe, etc. But I don't know. So I want to try, see what I get if I pick the Bane and the Beastmen being the same. Which of the two is it? That one. That was interesting. There's definitely evidence that they have been fighting the Bane, right? There's also evidence that one survived, that made sense to me. But I just don't know. So we don't get actually anything different as the last answer, I guess. Okay, I think I'll go with them being the enemies of the Bane, since they seem to neutralize them and the water and everything else, so I don't know. It might be just a matter of interpretation, having the player giving a potential answer to what he saw instead of the game giving you a specific answer. But who the hell knows? We could ask Obsidian, I guess. They would know. Alright, so let's go speak to Mel. And again, they need to do something about their loading in the new game. Hopefully they have streamlined that part of the engine so it can load faster. Meet up with Mel. That might have been the wrong teleporter. No, it wasn't. Oh, they're all here. Great. That's gonna go well. That means I kinda failed then, which I don't like. There must be a way to convince her to come back. I don't know if I didn't find something or going through the dialogue there at the end I didn't find the correct thing, because pretty sure there must be a way to convince her to come back, which means I just chose wrongly. Which means I will load and try that again.
That's it.
Smartest.
Yeah, yeah. We'll try that again. I want to convince her to come back. Huh. I really thought. That was it, but apparently not. I'm not sure what I'm missing. I think she's not convinced, that's why, although she goes, yes, that makes sense, then the next sentence is, no, I will go further into the depths. So you need to have a... Can I do it through dialogue though, or did I miss something before? I don't think I'd miss something. I don't think the game would let me miss something. So I'm missing something in the dialogue. That didn't give us. I don't think that's it, but I want to try different things. That makes sense. Okay. You know what? Let me... I wish you could press escape and go to load while you're in a dialogue. I think maybe I should have picked the... They are the stewards of the old wolves. Instead of picking, they are meant to fight the Bane. Which would make sense too. Plus, not both figures were actually trying to fight. One was anxious and afraid, and the other one was aggressive. All right. Maybe it's not right either. That makes no sense to me. See here, she says she will return, but then she goes on no. So I'm pretty sure that's a correct final answer, but the previous answers were not correct, that's why that's happening. Unless we are meant to go after her afterwards. She did say don't follow me or something. But it doesn't give us a way to follow her, so... That's annoying.
I got it. Can't do that.
Greetings, Archon. Of course. How can I help?
There we go. And I forgot the mic muted. well, I was reasoning that out. That's funny. Anyway. I knew there was something there. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping. Cool. Alrighty, there we go. Success, finally. And now we'll save. And I'm guessing she's gonna be there when we go out. Or she will come while we talk. We'll see. Damn, man, I don't want to play this game on an HDD. Again, the loading times are not extreme, but they're kinda annoying, even on an SSD. Playing on an HDD, I don't know. They would become really, really, really annoying. Funnily enough, I played Pillars of Eternity on one and I managed to finish it, so it wasn't that annoying. You must gather your party before venturing forth. That's funny. Callbacks to a previous era. Take your time. I wonder what the reason for that is, that you must gather your party. I mean, initially it might have been a technical reason, a technical limitation or something, but not now. Aha, see, there she is. Awesome. And we didn't actually fight here, which I expected we would. Yeah. What are you talking to? Come on. We'll of course pick here, which is why we went to the whole trouble of the animation failed there.
I got it.
Of getting here. Alright, where are we going? Teleport to the Wellsprint Cascade. Teleport. Through where? You got a keystone from Rift Talon that can be used on a teleporter near the Bastard Wounds Forge. Okay. So, there. I'm guessing this is the end of the DLC, which wasn't really substantial, time-wise. Nothing close to... What? The fuck? She was dead. I killed her already. How is she fighting me? What? What? That's obviously a bug. This DLC has a lot of bugs, which is weird. Let's not do that. I wouldn't expect that many bugs in a 5-hour DLC. Alright, dueling. Won't even use my powers that much. That was so weird. I'm guessing this happens if you don't kill her originally or something, but I already had killed her, so yeah. Again, this DLC has issues. Which was weird because the original game, the vanilla game, didn't have that many bugs that I remember. And in 5 hours I encountered one bug that required me to go back an hour because it was a GameStop bug and weird stuff like that. Anyway, as I said, nothing like the Pillars of Eternity DLC, which was meaty. This is a much shorter experience. And I think it's at the same price as that DLC too, so not really a cool thing. It is okay, but it is nothing special, and I don't think it... Well, let's finish it first, I guess, and we'll see. Alright, I'm guessing we'll fight the losers or the ones we don't pick. If I can find them somewhere. Unless it's a trap. Is he alive again? Amazing. Maybe it's not here. I thought it was here for a moment. These guys are both assholes. I haven't supported either of you, so I'm not sure what would you expect now for me to support you. Do I have anything else? No. I don't know why I couldn't tell them about them poisoning the farms. Yep, I can't actually say that. That alone makes them both unsuited to lead because they endanger the place.
I sure hope this is a wise decision. If we return to a den of sleepless, chances are we screwed up.
Nah, she got this.
The Beast Woman? Do you jest, Fatebinder? Or does this exploit some loophole in the Overlord's legal code?
I dare say she's probably the best hope for this place.
For sure. And again, they tried to kill their food just so to make the other person appear weak. Again, that's pretty cool. The way you are being judged, basically, from Judge Dredd in this world. Alright. Now, if it was a good choice, who knows? And that's it. Bastard's wound DLC done. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't anything great either. I found the story bits actually interesting. I liked the whole mural things, even though I failed hard to reach the proper conclusion. That's on me, not on the game. They kinda replicated the you must pick a side thing that the main game was all about, and the DLC was definitely way too short. Again, I need to check the price, but I think it was 20. Let me check. Just to be sure. Oh, it's 15. 15 is better, but it's still too much. Or, it's 5 hours, more or less. I guess you could have done it faster or slower too. 5 to 6 hours. It's not really that meaty. And for me, price matters. 15 is better than 20, that's for sure. The thing that they add to the game, again, the random encounters, might be something that adds to the value if you are new to the game, but as someone that had already finished the game, this wasn't anything close to, let's say, Hearts of Stone or Blood and Wine from The Witcher 3. But then, I guess it's not fair to compare it to probably the best expansions I've seen in a game. Still, I enjoy what I played. And I like Tyranny in general, so that's good. I like this game, I liked the world, and I liked the way it ended too. I wish we get a sequel, since they kinda left it on a cliffhanger, and I would like to see more, but who knows. Anyway, thanks for dropping by and watching the stream, I appreciate it. Feel free to click the follow button if you want to. If you watch on YouTube, feel free to do the same, leave a comment. I'll be back tomorrow with probably some Yakuza 0. Good night. On the lookout.